Being an intelligent feminine woman is very, very powerful. There's this misconception because of media that... Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I'm so happy you're here. I'm trying a little bit of different lighting, so I apologize if there are some shadows. I really just wanted to say welcome back to my channel, and for all of you women who are engaging with my content, I just cannot repeat enough how thankful I am for you, how you have honestly changed my life, because before this channel, I really felt kind of alone on a lot of these topics, kind of like I was just engaging with myself or perhaps a few people in my community. And now I have, I don't know what we are at right now in terms of numbers, but a few hundred of you who are following along on this journey, and it makes such a world of difference, and I just hope that I can continue to bring you some things that you believe are valuable. Today, we are going to branch off and talk about intelligence as a high-value feminine woman. So the misconception in society is that feminine women are dumb, and I want you to know that if somebody says that you are dumb, unless you have made a mistake that perhaps would have caused them to get a bad impression of you, a lot of times those people feel a sense of insecurity, and for women insulting women, it is actually a mating strategy that they might not know that they are implying that causes for them to want to hurt you so that you feel devalued, you do not project your femininity, and you kind of reduce yourself to that level of feeling not worth anything and not exuding your natural balance of femininity. So it's obvious that culture tells us that beautiful or feminine women, women that care about their appearance, you don't have to be like a size 2 Barbie, are unintelligent. Now, before we get into ways that you can develop your intelligence, I want you to recognize that that is false. Now, as a feminine woman, regardless of if somebody believes you're intelligent or not, you should know inside of yourself that you are intelligent. And as a high-value woman, you are going to want to continue to develop your intelligence throughout your life. It is true that we are born with a certain baseline of intelligence, but if you are watching this video and it piqued your interest, chances are you are not in that category of people where it would be difficult to elevate yourself to a higher level of intelligence. There are always ways we can better ourselves and be better members of this society, our community, and our families. As women who value homemaking, you especially want to develop your intelligence because you are the foundation of your home. Yes, you probably view your husband as the leader, but you are the backbone of the home. You are the greatest influence, usually, in an everyday basis for your children. You are going to be the one guiding them in knowledge most of the time because you are going to be the one who is around to do so. So you are going to want to develop your intelligence not for your own sake only, but for your children's sake. If you are a single woman, being an intelligent feminine woman is very, very powerful. There's this misconception because of media that very masculine men and successful men often go for dumb women. The problem is that that is not the average. Those are the exceptions that we see. And many times, even those women who portray themselves as dumb are actually not unintelligent in private. So to make yourself a better catch, you are going to want to be able to contribute intellectually to your husband's life. Without further ado, today I'm going to suggest some areas that you develop, that you nurture, in order to elevate your intelligence and grow in your femininity and value as a woman. Number one is your emotional intelligence. This is highly linked to the feminine woman. I encourage you to go through my playlist because the feminine woman is receptive and open to the emotions of others. If you have emotional intelligence and you are working in a feminine career, you are going to most likely succeed because emotional intelligence is often the driver in many areas of society. If you are a homemaker, this is especially important because you are going to want to be receptive to the emotions and the feelings of your family members so that you can help them and nurture them through life, give them a sense of comfort, be able to exude that softness that creates the feelings of warmth for a home. The second area I want you to begin developing is your academic intelligence. So what I mean by academic intelligence is your ability in everyday life, even when you go on Facebook and somebody posted some ridiculous study or some article stating a fact, you are going to want to be able to equip yourself with the tools to actually go look for the correct answers and to be open to opposing arguments. So what I mean by that, if somebody posts an article on Facebook saying Harvard University says that McDonald's French fries are excellent for your health, and everybody is believing this article about McDonald's French fries excellent for your health. So what you are going to want to do if you have an academic intelligence is get on Google Scholar or if you have a library card and go be able to look at actual studies and to look at the study that they cited in the article to be able to determine if those facts are indeed correct or not. With academic intelligence, I want to provide you with a few tips. This is honestly very easy, ladies. You go look for perhaps a concept that you think could be debunked. You go look in the literature. You go look at the authors of the study and the citations and where it has been studied. I once stumbled upon this article that was talking about this new program of education in my area, and they were raving about how it was excellent, and it kind of went a little bit against my logic because I thought opposite. So what I did was I actually looked at that article, I looked at the citations, and I found that it was the Ministry of Education citing the Ministry of Education. So is that very valuable, the Ministry of Education citing themselves? I don't think so. So then I hopped on Google Scholar and I actually went to look at the facts, and I was able to look at a countless number of studies that actually supported my argument. Why is this valuable as a feminine woman? Because you are going to want to be able to offer valuable advice to your husband, to your children, and you are going to want to help them reason through the misconceptions in this world. You do not have to act like a leader in this department, but you are going to be sought for advice in your everyday life from those people who love you. You are going to want to participate and contribute to the conversation. The third thing kind of branches off that. You are going to want to stay up to date on current events. So even if you are a full-time homemaker, you are going to want to consume news. Now, news is very corrupt nowadays. We know that is true. So I actually, if you have the capability to be able to filter yourself, you look at those news outlets that are actually opposing each other. Even if you are supporting one side, such as myself, over the other, you are still going to want to know what the other side is saying. Again, you're going to want to provide value in your relationships. You don't have to be the leader in this department, but I guarantee that your husband, if he is a masculine man, is going to want you to be able to contribute to the conversation. The fourth thing is I want you to work on your speaking and language skills. If you have noticed, my videos have gotten a little bit better from when I started. That is because I am practicing my presentation skills, which I haven't used in several years. And this is something that you can do in your daily life. You don't have to have a YouTube channel to do it. You can just begin talking to yourself aloud. I actually recommend that you do this in private. Talk to yourself aloud so you get into the habit of continually talking in longer and longer sentences without stumbling. This is incredibly difficult. You also want to continue to refine your language. I'm not the first person to have stated this. There are many different women and many different people talking about the ways that you can refine your language. For me, I have a specific emotional attachment to language because I speak two languages fluently, and keeping both of them up is very important for me. This helps develop the gray matter in your brain, which makes greater connection. Being able to speak with advanced language in perhaps your only language, or if you speak another language, being able to develop both at the same time is going to give you that same result. Like I said, I'm not the only one who's talked about this, so you can go out and seek those resources. I also encourage you to write. Write in a journal, write your thoughts down on sticky notes. I used to be a sticky note person. When I thought of a quote, I would just write it down and I would put it on my computer. Now I do it in my notebook. I do it on a bunch of drafts on my blog that don't really make it into videos or anything. I can show you my phone. It's full of drafts that didn't make it into a video. But the point is, you're going to want to also write down your thoughts. Communication is very feminine, so you're going to want to use this tool as your main tool to foster relationships. And practicing your communication in private is going to help you transition and use that communication in public settings to foster those relationships. The next thing I want to talk about is to encourage you to pursue your passion seriously. Pursuing your passion seriously also helps you deepen your understanding of something, whether that be sewing, gardening. When you are looking into bettering yourself into a type of skill, you are learning, and any type of learning is beneficial because it creates more connections in your brain, helps develop that gray matter, helps preserve your brain, and ultimately helps you in your relationships. I, of course, want you to also nourish your body. You're going to want to sleep whatever hour that is for yourself. For me, I do need to get more sleep. Try to incorporate a nap. A 15-minute nap actually can definitely help you. I'm not somebody who has children, although I did listen to a very helpful podcast the other day from a health coach who encouraged women, instead of, I don't know, doing whatever cleaning when they had children, to actually nap when their child is napping. Now, I don't have kids, so I can't give you an opinion on that. You will have to comment and let me know about that, how you can rest when you have kids. I would really like to know, because that is definitely in my future. You are also going to want to eat the proper foods for your body. So there are many resources on that. I love using Pinterest. There are so many diverse, so many ideas of brain food that is healthy for your food that you can incorporate into your daily life. The last point that I want you to encourage doing to develop your intelligence as a high value and feminine woman is, gonna get adjusted for this, is to surround yourself with quality people. So I like to surround myself with people who will make me better. Honestly, I like to surround myself with people who are better than me, because when you surround yourself with people who are better than you or people who inspire you, this causes for you to always pursue healthy progress. You have to know your boundaries. Don't practice jealousy. We can talk about this in another video. Learn to be happy for other people and their accomplishments. But it's really, once you get to that point of really being able to understand that God has blessed them with different things than you, and you are special in your own way, you will be able to use those relationships to help better yourself, and you will also be able to become the person that will get to a level where you will be able to simultaneously contribute to that relationship. So you will be fostering relationships, and they will also be feeding you, urging you to be a better and perhaps a more intelligent person. I value stimulating conversation, so being surrounded by people who I consider more intelligent than myself, that is one of the biggest factors why I married my husband, despite the fact that I believe he is my soulmate, is because he is more intelligent than I am. So listening to him helps me foster new ideas, and it helps me reconsider concepts that I had never thought about before. So that is all for today's video. If you have some tips, I would love to hear them. If you can leave a comment down below and let me know what you think, please don't forget to like this video because it helps other women find us in this community. I have big plans for this channel, and I'm really here to serve you. So please let me know the other types of videos that you would like for me to include. I'm here at your service, my lovely friends, and I hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.